In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And we gather to celebrate the great power of our God to heal us and to lift us up and to make us whole in every way. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal us of every ill and division. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, draw near to your servants and answer our prayers with unceasing kindness, so that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In the beginning of the reign of King Zedekiah, king of Judah, in the fifth month of the fourth year, the prophet Hananiah, son of Azur from Gibeon, said to me in the house of the Lord, in the presence of the priests and all the people, "Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I will break the yoke of the king of Babylon. Within 2 years I will restore to this place all the vessels of the temple of the Lord, which Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, took away from this place to Babylon. And I will bring back to this place Jeconiah, son of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, and all the exiles of Judah who went to Babylon, says the Lord. For I will break the yoke of the king of Babylon." The prophet Jeremiah answered the prophet Hananiah in the presence of the priests and all the people assembled in the house of the Lord and said, "Amen. Thus may the Lord do. May he fulfill the things you have prophesied by bringing the vessels of the house of the Lord and all the exiles back from Babylon to this place. But now listen to what I'm about to state in your hearing and the hearing of all the people. From of old, the prophets who were before you and me prophesied war, woe, and pestilence against many lands and mighty kingdoms. But the prophet who prophesies peace is recognized as truly sent by the Lord, only when his prophetic prediction is fulfilled." Thereupon the prophet Hananiah took the yoke from the neck of the prophet Jeremiah and broke it and said in the presence of all the people, "Thus says the Lord, even so, within 2 years I will break the yoke of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, from the neck of all the nations." At that, the prophet Jeremiah went away. Sometime after the prophet Hananiah had broken the yoke from off the neck of the prophet Jeremiah, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah, "Go tell Hananiah this. Thus says the Lord, by breaking a wooden yoke, you forge an iron yoke. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, a yoke of iron I will place on your necks, and the necks of all those nations serving Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon. And they shall serve him, even the beasts of the fields I give him." To the prophet Hananiah, the prophet Jeremiah said, "Hear this, Hananiah, the Lord has not sent you, and you have raised false confidence in this people. For this, says the Lord, I will dispatch you from the face of the earth. This very year you shall die, because you have preached rebellion against the Lord." That same year, in the seventh month, Hananiah the prophet died. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Remove from me the way of falsehood and favor me with your law.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Take not the word of truth from my mouth, for in your ordinances is my hope.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Let those turn to me who fear you and acknowledge your decrees.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Let my heart be perfect in your statutes, that I be not put to shame.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Sinners wait to destroy me, but I pay heed to your decrees.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
From your ordinances I turn not away, for you have instructed me.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
The The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side of the sea while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was alone there. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them, walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." After making the crossing, they came to the land of Gennesaret. When the men of that place recognized him, they sent word to all the surrounding country. People brought to him all those who were sick and begged him that they might touch only the tassel on his cloak. And as many as touched it were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This week we remember, or we have the date of the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And I see they're already having articles about it being 75 years ago. And it was an awful thing. But it brings to mind one of the, there are two fallacies, intellectual dishonesty about history. One is archaicism, and that means you bring back from the past what is what needs to be in the present. So think of, if somebody had an eye problem, would you say, "Well, Jesus spit on the ground and made some dirt and put it on the guy's eye and he was healed, so go do that." No, you go to an eye doctor. So archaicism means you think the only thing that works is what was old or past. The other one is anachronism, and anachronism is when you put back into history what applies right now. So there are a lot of people think that the bombing, atomic bombing then, was immoral, and it is an awful, shameful thing. Well, except we weren't there. And so it's very anachronistic to push back into those people's minds or that time the moral sensitivity we have now. So we might think it's awful now, and it would of course be awful now, but that is not how you think about it, because that was then. And you simply can't make judgments about morality, about what those people did at the time, because we weren't there, and you don't know what they're up against. The gospel here is, of course, Jesus walking on the water, and it's kind of important to keep in mind this only happened once in history. So if you have somebody who thinks they walk on water, or you say somebody says so-and-so thinks they walk on water, they're wrong. It only happened one time. It was Jesus. I love the stories about Jesus healing, and to me, it's just an incredible power and a great sign of the kingdom of God's desire. God's desire for us to be totally whole and healed in every possible way, body and spirit. But there's so many of them we don't really know. I mean, you read about them, what were they healed of? So Jesus healed all these different maladies of people. He brought to them all those who were sick and begged them to touch him. Well, we don't know what they were sick of, and we don't know what they were healed of. I love the story of years ago. There was a family that was very poor, lived in Appalachia, and they had one son. And somewhere early on, when he was 5 or 10 or so, For Christmas, they bought the family a mirror. And the boy's face was very disfigured. And he had never seen his face. So when they got this mirror, they were looking in the mirror, and the boy realized, "Oh my gosh, what's wrong with my face? My face looks so awful." And they said, "It doesn't look awful to us, it might look awful to you." But he said, I've been that way all my life." He says, "Yeah." Well, his parents said, "That doesn't matter. We love you just the same. We're going to keep on loving you regardless of how your face looks now or looked then." And sometimes We have a sense of what we need to be healed of. Sometimes we have a sense of we need to be healed of the wrong thing. And one of the great things about the penitential rite is, Lord, you come to heal us of sin and division. And sometimes I suspect that a lot of the healing Jesus did was a healing of the heart and spirit, that healed the people of their grief or their loss or the division within them or some other hurt that went along, not just the physical thing. And of course, he cast out demons. We're not sure what those meant, but he freed people from all sorts of slavery and all sorts of mental constrictions or whatever it was at the time. So now, in this first reading, you have Jeremiah calling out Hananiah as a false prophet. And Jeremiah had this wooden yoke on him, and the prophet Jeremiah took it off and broke it and said, this is how it's going to be. And Jeremiah says, yeah, you broke the wooden one, but God is going to put an iron one on Nebuchadnezzar and all his people. And in some way, yeah, the Israelites thought of it as a way of thinking about sometimes people go from one slavery to another. And sometimes when we think about what do we need to be healed of, it's what is it we have enslaved ourselves to? What is some indulgence or some pleasure or some part of our identity or some whatever it is that has enslaved us? That we feel we are duty-bound, this is who we are. And sometimes God needs to heal us of that. It's so hard to know what we need to heal of, but of course with the Black Lives Matter and the Blue Lives Matter and all that ugliness and all that violence and all that injustice, how do we start? Well, I don't know that anybody knows how. I certainly don't. But it is a part of the sadness and it's a part of the grief. And it's something that we dearly, dearly need to be healed of. And sometimes I know how to pray about that, sometimes I don't. But it is only the Lord Jesus with the power of the kingdom that can help us with that. And in the gospel there, Peter says, Jesus, help me. Years ago, I went to see a guy who was dying, a really good old guy, and he was kind of not very talkative, and he said, well, Father, what's your best prayer? I said, well, my best prayer, my first prayer is, God, help me. And he kind of was quiet, and he said, okay, what's your second best prayer? And my second best prayer is, God, I need a little help here. And most of us need some help. Sometimes we need healing, sometimes we need peace, sometimes we need hope. We never know what we need to be healed of. Today's another day when Jesus brings a lot of hope and incredible goodness just by saying, I want to heal you. And people knew that, they brought it, and they worked. Let us stand and pray. And first we pray for our church, especially our Pope, that he might know real strength and full support from all of us who follow the Lord Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who live in a healing world, those who bring healing to those who are in great need, especially in the ICU and with the COVID, and those who are help to people who are somehow in grief, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who need financial assistance, those who have lost all sorts of things in this pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who seek peace and seek unity for our country and our families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are addicted to anger or fear or violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are peacemakers, or those who help us know how to more deeply respect each other, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those with a terminal illness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our church, that it be a church that all want to come to, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Holy God, you give us Jesus the healer to know your full love for all people. Open our hearts to his power for goodness around us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the land and work of human hands. It will become the bread of our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all this holy church.
O God, graciously sanctify these gifts, and accepting the offering of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed us anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, number one.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Joseph our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And let us pray for the fullness of God's kingdom of forgiveness and healing in the words that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Yeah.
The body of Christ.
Let us pray. O God, give your people a constant protection so that those you renew with these heavenly gifts and in your never-failing care for us, make us worthy of eternal salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Heavenly Father, bless our diocese with the grace of many vocations, to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life. Through the intercession of the Blessed Mother, grant to those you have called the willingness and generosity of spirit of giving themselves and their children, lives and their talents to the service of our Lord and to His Church. Increase the faith of all within our diocese, and especially the faith of those you are calling. We ask this through Christ, your Son, our Lord.